The Worthing Portrait Artist of the Year competition has been running for 3 years and has become a prestigious event that attracts many entrants from artists and art enthusiasts alike. I was invited to the event by its curator, Cathy Verney, who was excited to welcome a fantastic selection of sitters and judges. The special guest celebrity sitter is international best-selling writer Peter James, who has sold over 20 million copies of his crime novels, which were also translated to dozens of languages and adapted to stage and television. Peter is joined by fellow sitters, Brighton-based best-selling author Shani Struthers and Billy the Brush Mumford, also known as the most prolific art forger.
Let's start with you. This is the third time that the competition is taking place in Worthing.
Yes.
So tell me a little bit about it. What, is it completely like the format of the national event? People sitting down being painted?
Yes, it is. The idea was based on the Sky Arts programme, where we just limit it to 4 hours and it's painted live. And we selected three sitters because we've got the space to spread them out and it would allow us to have a good number of artists come in. They're local artists. They can apply within 20 miles of Worthing. We've got a couple this year that have been in it before, but we also have quite a few new ones this year who are very excited.
Last year, the competition didn't take place because of the restrictions. Mm. And the year before, one of the sitters was David Henty here. He's already posing nicely. But you're not a sitter this year.
No.
This year, we actually have people who David kindly arranged for.
We do, yes. We have Shani Struthers, who's a local author.
She's a best-selling author.
Best-selling author. And we also have Billy the Brush Mumford, who is a renowned copyist, who also lives... Forger. He's a forger, okay. And then we have Peter James, who is a world-renowned author. So really excited to get him.
It's a really exciting variety of sitters. David, let's move over to you. So for the very few viewers who don't know who you are, you are the judge this year. You're famous for being, well, I would say... the world's number one art forger. Or a copyist, to use Cathy's word. Tell me just a little bit about that. What does that mean? You make a living?
I make a very good living copying art, and I'm in galleries around the country, and I've got loads of private clients and stuff. And so I copy paintings from anything from Caravaggio to Lowry. They're works of art in their own right now. Can I just mention, Billy's the most prolific art forger, and I'm the best.
Right. Billy's watching us now.
He's the most prolific. He gets up earlier than me.
That's the distinction.
But I'm the best.
So this year, you're going to be sitting and judging, looking at other people's art, making comments. How difficult is that going to be, do you think, for you?
I've been in front of a few judges, but I've never been a judge. So it's a new perspective from my point of view.
9 artists, carefully selected as a result of a rigorous process, will be painting live to produce a finished portrait of their celebrity in just 4 hours, and will try to win the prestigious award of Worthing Portrait Artist of the Year 2021.
So here we are, and I'm here with Cathy Verney, the event organizer. The atmosphere is quite incredible here, and I bet you're really excited. It's been a lot of work.
It has, yes. It takes months to get to this point, and it's been a busy week getting everything set up. But it's always worth it when you see everything come together. The artists are here waiting, they're anticipating everything, the sitters are in place, people are coming in. It's going to be buzzing. They're going to love the atmosphere in the room during the 4 hours that they're painting. And I'm tired, but it's such a great event. And I've got a bit of butterflies, but it's going to be a good night.
Great, I can't wait.
The artists are at the ready by their canvases, while the sitters make themselves as comfortable as possible for the next 4 hours. The competition is about to start.
Ready, steady.
Paint.
I just got special permission to interrupt the process for 2 minutes, and we're going to find out how Peter is doing.
Strange that sitting being, but I've got earbuds, so I'm listening to audiobooks.
So I'm cheating,
yeah. Well, I think it's helping me concentrate, so I feel I'm being, you know, in character with what's required. You know. I think the old notion of just, you know, the artist sitting like this as a dummy, it's really hard. I mean, but just having the earpods, I asked them and they, none of them minded. It means I can listen to a book. So I'm reading a book while I'm just sitting here. Yeah, otherwise, yeah. It's like 4 hours of vacuum.
And it is, you know, some people do it for a living and it is very, very hard to just sit there. Have you seen any of the work so far?
I kind of deliberately not yet. I thought I'd wait until the finish, because I know I hate anybody to see one of my books when it's kind of a work in progress. So I kind of feel, out of respect to these painters and the guy's drawing, that I should let them finish it before I go, oh my God. I mean, let me just frame this in that I don't think I'm expecting this to look like, make me look like George Clooney or Brad Pitt. And it's probably going to make me look like some ridiculous sort of fat old geezer with a big nose and fuzzy hair, because that's how I always tend to view all the kind of, every time I see myself on television I think, who's that? Was it Robbie Burns said, would that the world could see us the way we see ourselves.
So you've been painting Peter James?
I have, yes.
What do you think about the process so far? How has it been?
It's interesting. It's quite a challenge. The time goes really fast. I was a finalist 2 years ago, so I was prepared for that because that's what I found before as well. So I'm using pigment markers, Posca pens as they're often called, and I like a lot of colour in my artwork. I'm also a mural painter and I do graphic design and sign writing as well. And so I wanted to kind of do something really colourful. He has an interesting face to draw. I slightly have moved around. I'm not quite drawing the side profile that I have from the seat. But obviously, if you were doing a normal portrait, you would have a bit more flexibility about where you sat. So I took some reference pictures to work from as well.
We're halfway through the process and mm-hmm. you've been painting Peter James.
Yeah.
How's it been going?
It's been really good. Yeah, it's a bit of a fidget, but I caught a photo, so I've been working from that, did a sketch, blocked in all the colour, and I'm just going to start putting in the detail now. I think the lightness is okay, so overall I'm pretty happy with it.
Would it help you to know about the person or not, or it doesn't matter at all?
I don't think it matters, because I've had a chat with him, had a bit of fun with him, so it's more about his character, I guess, rather than his books. There's been a TV show recently, one of his books, so I've enjoyed that. But no, it's more about talking to him and getting to know his character. And I caught the photo I've been working from, he was smiling. So he's been listening to an audiobook, so he's been quite stern, I guess, with his expression. You can see him now, he's just sitting there. In about 5 minutes, he'll wriggle all over the place and he'll start looking everywhere. So if you stayed like that all night, it'd be really easy. But he keeps wriggling. So I'm having to refer to the photo and just use him for colouring, really. And yeah, trying to get that last hour, maybe I'll refer to him more, capture his character.
My name is Alan Knight, and I'm a new co-owner of the venue here in Worthing.
We're in an absolutely fabulous venue. So tell me a bit about the history of this place and what you're hoping to make of it.
St. Paul's, as it was previously known, it is a 208-year-old church. It's owned by the Church of England, and we've taken control of it to renovate it, bring it up to a good standard, and then we're going to promote for the people of Sussex live music entertainment, and that can be anything from Elvis impersonators, tribute acts, all the way through to
art competitions.
Yes, exactly, art competitions. Portrait Artist of the Year. So it's a wonderful space here in Worthing that we hope to maximise.
So I have two important Davids with me just now. David Henty, the head judge. And David Freud, you're here as a celeb guest, and you've also kindly donated some of your work for today. So let's start with you, David. Do you want to tell me a little bit about what kind of artist are you and why are you here today?
I'm a playful artist, I suppose. I try to do a different style each time I do a show, but mostly figurative oil paintings is the kind of easiest, obvious thing to do. But when I'm asked to do a show, I try and do something I haven't done before so that it's a stretch for me, so that I don't know what I'm going to produce. And I've been sort of chairman of this St Paul's in Worthing for a few years before I passed that role on last year, and that involved helping Cathy put on events like this. So we've had a couple of Portrait Artists of the Year here before, and I've judged and presented and stuff, but not painted.
Head judge, what's your impression so far?
Oh, I love it. Do you know the talent? You know, because everyone's different. When we picked them, all the artists were different styles, you know, because you don't want everyone looking the same. And there's so many different people, and you wonder what they're going to make, you know, because, you know, these styles are not my style, but, you know, someone's got one style, someone else is doing with pen, and you think it's brilliant, you know, and I'm just really sort of waiting to see what they produce. I've been round, and there's some really good, you know, some people have got it already, you know, but no, I'm really excited. I use it for mental health. Some days you're on top, and some days you're having a bad day, you're down there, you know. You know, when it's going well, we're on top of the world, nothing could be wrong. But when you have a down day, you can't get in that, you know, groove. Oh, it's like, you think it's the end of the world, you know.
What I like about this event, or these kind of events, is sort of, there's such a sort of delicate balance between, like, they're given a set amount of time, and sometimes they've got a fantastic piece of artwork after 2 hours, 20 minutes, and after 4 hours, they've got nothing. It's all gone. And so kind of knowing when a piece is, you know, is good enough is really kind of an art that these artists learn. Certainly the ones that have come back a second time you'll see they've bought a second canvas so that they can stop.
Right.
And they don't have to just carry on with the same picture.
So, Debbie, you're an artist and an art teacher, but you're here today as a visitor.
Yeah.
What do you think about it so far? We are kind of two-thirds, I think, into the competition.
Yeah, it's exciting and interesting to see how the different way, different ways people are working.
Because you also run, well, not competitions, but you have live classes with live sitters in Brighton.
Yeah. I run, life drawing and portraiture, but also one-off clothed sessions. So I'm used to trying to get people to focus on drawing for a couple of hours or 10 minutes or something. So similar to what they're doing here, really.
So Mia, you came here as a guest today, and you're an art student yourself. What do you think about today's event?
Yeah, it's really cool to see such a variety of styles and mediums. And it's just like interesting to see the process for the different artists.
What do you think of the concept? I mean, so often artists kind of, you know, they sit and create on their own. And this is sort of showbiz in a way, and art. Is that something that appeals to you?
Yeah, why not? It's quite an isolated or introverted practice. So it doesn't make much of a difference to have other people if you just get in the zone, I guess.
Billy the Brush has been the most professional sitter, sitting here without moving at all, but I am going to interrupt his, well, meditation perhaps. Billy, would you speak to me for a minute?
Yeah, certainly will. I think it might, 1.5 bottles of wine at lunch might help.
Ah, you know, so that's a secret.
Yeah, it's like comatose, you know.
And you are an artist yourself.
Yes.
Does that make it
harder in a way to sit here and expect other people to produce art?
It's difficult because it's the first time I've ever done it, and I work 7 days a week as a painter, and I work maybe 8-10 hours a day in my studio, and so I don't, I'm rather reclusive. I don't go out much, so I got prized out of the studio by David and got talked into this, which I'm really enjoying, and you know, I can't wait to see the artists sort of work, basically. I admire them.
Did you see any during the break?
Or no, not at all, because I thought that would maybe put, like Brock, a bad luck on them, so for me to look at them. So, no, I'd like to see the finished work, and I eagerly await it, because they're very, very clever people, and it was never, though I've been a painter for 50 years, it was never in my skill set to be able to do portraits, and it's a talent I do admire.
Just one more comment. You're not just an artist, you're also an art forger.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about that.
I got into the best at the time art school in London, possibly in the UK, St. Martin's. And I got thrown out after, 18 months, I think. I was thrown out of art college on a Tuesday and sold my first still wet Renoir in Portobello Road in London on the Saturday. So it didn't take me long to realise that it's all right reading about artists who are broke and have nothing to eat and, you know, penniless. But when you are actually one, in the sudden realisation, you have to do something. So I chose that path, and it's as simple as that. I'm not like David. David is a superb, world-renowned copyist. I don't do copies. I take pieces from an artist's work and forge them all together into a new painting, one they may have painted and got lost, or one they gave to a friend, or one day maybe just thinking about, and it's only just been rediscovered. So that's what I do. The French call it pastiche, you know.
I entered, let me see, was it back in March, I believe? And I actually entered for the Sky Arts as well, and for that you need a self-portrait. So I did the one that has been on display in the small room there. I was very pleased to be accepted for this. I did it 2 years ago, and they had a competition for the public had to vote for the most popular one, and I was pleased to win that. I do like pastels when I'm doing a portrait, because you can get a very quick effect. I like to keep the colours fresh if I can. I think with other media, it's very easy to get rather muddy colours if you're not careful, and with pastels, keep them, don't mix them up too much. Well, that's my style anyway. I know lots of artists do. There's no rules about this sort of thing. They tend to have your own rules, basically.
I have been painting Billy the Brush. I think we're in the third hour now, so I've gone a bit giddy, but I think it's going okay. I feel like the bulk of it is now done, so I'm just trying not to fiddle with it too much to spoil it. But he's been amazing. He's sat like an absolute rock. Unbelievable. He's been a complete legend, so we're really lucky to have had him. I'm not sure he's enjoying it quite so much, because it's quite hard work sitting so
still. It's difficult to
know. But he's sitting so still, it's brilliant. I work in oils, and so I'm using oil paint, and I'm painting on paper. I could have painted on something different, but I think I was trying to keep the pressure low, so instead of bringing a big canvas in, I thought, I'm just going to bring paper, because I can have more sheets of paper, so if it doesn't work, I can just keep bringing out the paper. So I've just I try and keep a fairly simple palette, so I haven't got too many colours going on in it, and then hopefully it should all tie in. That's the theory anyway. So far I think I'm quite pleased with it. It's been quite a challenge, because Billy has his hat, his signature hat, yes, and sunglasses, and quite often when I paint I really focus on eyes. so that's been a challenge. He's so cool. So I'm almost, if I do finish early, I might do a special painting of his leopard print DMs, his shoes, because yes. They're so cool. They almost deserve their own portrait.
Cathy, you are the organiser of today's fabulous event. How has it been for you so far?
It's been a great evening so far. The artists are all doing well. They're all enjoying the experience, which is the key thing. And there's a buzz about the room now that portraits are starting to come to life.
Is it as lively and as creative as you expected it to be?
Yes. Yes. This is the third one we've done, and it's been just as good as the other two. People who come here, they love to see the live portraiture. They're interested in who the sitters are, and they're going to hang around till the end of the evening to see who wins overall.
Do you have any bets on the winner?
I've got a couple that I think should probably be in the top three, but I'm not going to say who. Knowing the artists, I'm a bit biased.
So we'll wait till the end of the evening.
I think so.
Thank you, Cathy.
Thank you.
So you are the judge, together with David Henty, of today's competition.
That's correct, yes.
And we're literally about to
enter
come
the last
to an
hour,
end.
Aren't we? Yes, and it's quite fascinating because when we started off, some of them were quite slow to start off with, and then we went out for 40 minutes, came back, and it's just like, wow, some of these have moved along, and there are people on the canvas now, and some of them are absolutely outstanding. You can see why they've been selected.
So you were involved with the selection process?
I wasn't, no. Oh. I was pulled in after they'd selected everybody, so it's good for me because I have no history with any of these artists, so I'm coming to them all sort of brand new, so it makes me very, very impartial.
Shani, we just got permission to interrupt for 2 minutes or so. How's it been sitting like this for hours?
It's hard work, just sort of gazing wistfully into the distance. But yeah, it's hard work. My neck hurts. But it's fine, it's fun. And the time does go very quickly.
Does
so,
it?
Yeah. Yeah,
and any grand ideas for a next book or something?
No, I'm just dozing and, you know, with my eyes open, really. So now I'm having a break from thinking about books for today.
So you're a writer?
Yes.
Much like Peter James, who's sitting over there.
Yes.
Is this the first time you're being portrayed?
Yes.
This is a
first for me. Yes, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. It's good fun. It's nice. Yeah. I'm really looking forward to seeing the finished results. From what I've seen so far, there's some amazing, they're all amazing paintings.
So have you seen some of the paintings of you?
Yes.
You have?
I did have a peek, yeah. I wasn't supposed to, but I did. So yeah, I can't wait to see them.
Any favourites so far, or you do want to reserve judgment to the end?
They're all so different, actually. I know Jake Fern's work, and I was very excited to be painted by him. I must admit, when I knew that he was painting me, I was like, yeah, and I love it. It's going to be hard to choose one. It's going to be hard to choose one out of any of these. How they do it, I don't know.
How is it to paint Shani?
It's lovely, yeah. I've met her a couple of times. I'm quite pleased, and I think it's turned out all right. And I think she's a nice model. Yeah, very nice, yeah.
Is this what you do full time?
It is, as of about 18 months ago. So I used to do Photoshop retouching, photographic retouching. And that dried up because of this mild flu that's going around. And so I started doing what I've always wanted to do and what I had done before, but not professionally. So I kind of dived in. So now I do it professionally, and I'm building up a kind of a base. So yeah, I'm available for commissions.
Mark and Daryl, you've been sitting here very quietly. Are you enjoying the evening? Daryl, let's start with you.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Very pleasant evening, yeah.
And you're an artist as well, right?
I do some drawing and painting, yes, yeah.
You're quite mysterious.
I wouldn't say I was an artist. I'm learning, shall we say.
Okay. And Mark, you, I hear, are the previous winner of this very competition.
I was.
Tell me about your work. What was it?
Who was it? She was the High Sheriff. High Sheriff. So she had all the gear on and, all sorts of stuff.
When you say all the gear, it actually sometimes makes it harder to create a portrait because of the gear.
Yeah, she had kind of like ruffly bits, which isn't right, actually. She just cracked that in with a bit of white paint at the end of it. So, yeah.
We're now going to invite each sitter in turn to review their three portraits. And we're going to start with Shani. So if David could pop over and help Shani review her three portraits.
Wow, the colours on that are lovely. They've all got something really amazing about them. Mm-hmm. That how do you choose, really?
Oh, because it's all lined up on the stage.
Oh, wow.
I like that a lot. It's really nice.
Everybody, we have deliberated and finally selected our top three artists from this evening. But before we announce the three top winners, I would like to thank you all for coming and supporting this event again in our third year. I would like to thank all the artists for their contribution and their hard work tonight. I'm sure you'll agree it's been an amazing evening of live portraiture. I would also like to thank our sitters for their time and their patience. So without further ado, let's announce the winners. In third place, we have Sarah Reeve with her portrait of Billy. Congratulations. In second place, we have a lovely portrait of Shani by Jake Fern. And our overall winner of Worthing Portrait Artist of the Year 2021 with his full-length portrait of Billy is Dominic Simpson.
There you have it. Another Worthing Portrait Artist of the Year competition has come to an end. Sitters Peter James, Billy the Brush and Shani Struthers can now stretch their legs. And the artists can relax their hands. It's been an intense 4 hours for both groups. And who knows what ideas may have been formed in the sitters' heads during these hours? There may even be an art forger featuring in Peter James's next book.